What I've done is to show you the endless possibilities with this is you can also take go from a food medium into a non-food medium. It's going to be the same strokes that you're going to learn on the cake, but these are actually glass paints. So again, you would have a separate set of brushes that would be non-food marked. And with this, what's really neat about these glass paints is I did etch this plate, and you can use in any etching product that's available in a craft store. It's a liquid etch. And the reason I liquid etch this too is because of the fact that it gives it more of a tooth to hold on to with the paint. But you go ahead and paint this, and it either takes a week for it to dry, or you can set it in a cold oven at 150 for 30 minutes, pull it out, let it cool down, and it's set. And you can actually hand wash these. So I've done some events where I've actually painted the dessert plates or painted the wine glasses to match the cake. So if you're real creative in doing anything like this, I'm telling you what, that is a huge, huge upsell for you. So kind of cute. And then I have people that actually collect these. They'll mount them up on little easels. So that's another idea. Now, before we get into the painting too, good idea is whenever I develop a project, I always start with a file folder. And on this, I just took an 8-inch round and I just kind of drew a circle here. And I painted it on a piece of paper first to just kind of see where the lay of the design would be and what colors I might be using. Good thing to always practice on a sheet of paper first. And then what I did down here is I have a color legend which I list the colors I used and then the brushes that I used. And what I do is I file these away because if you ever need to do it again, it's so much easier just to pull the file out and to pull all your supplies out, and that way you're not being counterproductive. I only like to do things once. The other thing too is a lot of people when they first started painting these cakes, it was hysterical. My first painted cake, I got the cake covered, I was ready to go, I loaded up my paintbrush, and I was like this. No, I can't do it. And the reason being is I thought, oh my gosh, if I make a mistake, I can't do anything with this fondant, I'm gonna have to start all over again. So when I first started painting cakes, a little word to the wise, is I would cut round gum paste or fondant plaques, and I would paint those. Then I would attach them to the cake and put some kind of little like a star, or not a star border, but a shell border around them. And I put parchment paper underneath so the people could actually lift those up and take them off. I do have a client that collects those plaques. I went over to her house one day to deliver a cake because she asks for different scenes all the time now. And she had actually taken them and shadow box mounted them on her wall. So all of these cakes that I painted for her, they're now collector's items on the wall, which is kind of funny. You just never know where your stuff's gonna end up. So again, if you're afraid to do the cake, you're afraid you might make a mistake, go ahead and do it on a plaque first. And they've got those real fancy plaque cutters that you can buy. Those are really nice to cut as well. So this helps, little helpful hints there. Okay, we are getting ready to paint. Now, this cake, actually, and this cake stand, this is another thing. This is actually a tilting cake stand. So this thing can be turned up to where it's straight. Or when you're painting, especially if you're at an angle, you can angle it down. And because it's got non-skid on it, as you can see, and real cake, I mean, this is not just styrofoam, real cake, it's not moving. So this was something that I found again, and I use the heck out of it, especially in painting. It's hard to paint down on top of a flat surface, looking down on it sometimes, and especially when you get to the edges out here. As you can see, it's gonna be kind of hard to look at an edge and paint it straight on. So this could be an invaluable tool. And you might have to talk to Yummy Arts and Michael and maybe Susan who could find this if anybody's really interested in it. Okay, we're gonna get ready to paint. I'm gonna go ahead and remove this and we're gonna set up.